You opened last week, didn't you, actually? So you are...
Is it 2 weeks ago?
Is it 2 weeks?
No, last week.
Oh, it feels like
seems
two.
Like 2 weeks.
Coming well.
Shows in. There's so many in.
This was a box that you wanted to tick, the West
Absolutely. End. Absolutely. And it was one of those things where... Because I started in theater in school and then went straight to television and then film. And it was like the one thing that I said when I get to that point in my career where I can go back to Broadway and be on stage. But never in a million years did I think it'd be the West End, because it's like, you know, the Bard, Shakespeare. It's like, that's really
the Phoenix Theatre as well. So,
yeah.
I mean,
and the Phoenix, yeah.
Olivier's
Laurence Theater. Olivier, yeah, man, yeah. It's definitely a dream come true.
And what a role as well. I mean, Chicago is an... I mean, the music, everything about Chicago, just love it. But Billy, as a role, just explain a little bit about his character.
Well, he's a criminal defense attorney, and he's in this jail with all these women, helping them to, you know, beat their cases. And he's very good at what he does, you know. Very manipulative. He's like almost like the B.T. Barnum and Bailey. He's like the ringleader, ringmaster, you know. Mm-hmm. And to be able to play on stage with Ruthie and Josephina and all of these wonderful women who bring such, you know, just magic to the production is it was a dream come true.
Well, you've got three big songs as well, haven't you? One of them is Razzle Dazzle. So is he your Billy? Is he very soulful?
Oh yeah, you know, he got a little soul in him. Got a little more color than the other Billys, you know. you know, he does a little modern. Some of the moves are a little modern, but it's still the spirit of him, you know, coming in and capturing and manipulating and being charismatic and having a good time doing it.
So Ruthie, for you, I mean, accepting the role in Chicago, it must be a bit like coming home for you.
Yes.
Of course, but with a bit of a difference.
Yes, I always refer to Chicago as the gift that keeps on giving because I keep going back to this show, and if you talk to anybody in the cast, they've all done it before and you all want to come back because it is pure showbiz. I mean, it's not about the set, it's not about this, you know, it's about the performances and, of course, the band and that you've got live on stage every night. And so... It is an incredible show, especially for me as a woman, to play these strong, fabulous women.
Haven't you broken a record by doing this? Aren't you now the only person that's played all three female leads? Wow. So Roxy, Velma, and now Mama.
Yeah. That is amazing.
Yeah,
that is incredible.
So you were going to initially they asked you to do Velma, and you said, I've done that one.
I said, I've done that one. I think a more interesting choice might be, you know, Mama. And they went, oh. And so we had a talk about it, and I didn't know whether it would be my cup of tea. I didn't know whether I was a mama. So we had a little play around, and I thought, I really like this woman. And I like the fact that there are times when I just get to watch all you lot.
Well, you've got time backstage on your own. Have they put you a card table there?
They
you're playing cards, so
she's the real mama of the cast. Don't let her kid you. There's this area where they don't let anybody go, but she's like, no, you can let us go, and I'll look after everybody. And if they mess up, they'll answer to her. We were like, okay, yes.
Oh, well, I can imagine that. But I can also see you at your own card table sitting there whilst they're all on stage.
This is Ruthie's corner.
You have to play solitaire because you're on your own.
I know, but you know the other thing is, and this tells you who I am as well, is that the stage manager Sarah actually put a very large shh in duct tape, so that I kept quiet.
Oh,
because
too much talking.
Too much talking, too much fun.
Do you know what the only problem with you playing that role is? You two don't get a song together, do you?
This is my we were saying this yesterday that the only thing I feel a bit kind of. Is we don't really get anything to do with each other. A couple of glances. But you have to see this man's Billy Flynn. It is like nothing. It's like no Billy you've ever seen.
Really?
The man is an Oscar winner, and you see that plain and simple on a stage. There is a reason why this man is where he is. And it's, you know, not only is he a fantastic actor, but he's so likeable and lovable on that stage.
What do you think about her?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, what do I do after this? Marry me.
And is the West End what you wanted it to be?
Yes, everything, every day. You know, like you had said earlier, when that band starts to play those songs to start the musical off, it puts you right into character. Mm. It really does. And then the way it's everything's lit. And Bob Fosse was so simplistic in his movements, his lighting, his arrangements, but yet so impactful. Every little thing, the iconography of the, you know, the noose hitting the floor and then the spotlight of that and that picking up, representing the body and stuff. It's really been magical.
How long have we got you there for, both of you, or is that yet to be decided? Don't know yet.
Well, for now, till the end of June.
So just hurry up and get there, basically, just to make sure you get
it's to the 23rd of June, I think, is your, was when it
Something
finishes.
Like that, yes.
Never an empty seat. Well, maybe one or two.
They're going nuts.
Yeah. I'm not surprised.
They stand in the back. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
20 years ago, it's the same. It's the same reaction, you know, opening it 20 years ago and coming back, you think, is it going to be the same? Is it going to be quite...
Well, with you two, it can't go wrong, that's for sure.
We're having fun.
It's really lovely to see you.
It's lovely to see you.
It's really lovely to have you here as well.